Hi, and welcome to this video tutorial about Vision LiDAR 2020 on point cloud extraction from photos. Now, in Vision LiDAR, you have a tool which will allow you to do the extraction from photos, which is located in Tools, SFM, and we'll start with the first step, which is 3D reconstruction. You have three fields. In the first one, we will select the folder in which all the images are. Secondly, we'll select the folder where we will create the project. And third one is just to give a name to the project. Once it's done, you just click on Reconstruct. The software will start the reconstruction from the photos. And once it's done, you press Enter to close the window. If you have any GCPs, you can then, in second step, edit the GCP for your point cloud to have a georeference. If you don't, you can skip directly to the third step, which is densify, still in tool SFM. And you will go select the .bim file created within your project folder. Once selected, you click Open. Once it is done, you will be asked to open the project. So the densification will create both a VLP project from Vision LiDAR, but will also in the folder create a LAS file, which can be used to create another project. Note that the point cloud created will be in RGB, and from that point cloud you will be able to start doing your extraction features or your classification, for example. Once the reconstruct is done, we'll go to SFM DCP editor. First off, we have to open the .bin which was created during the reconstruction, which is located within your project created. Then we will click on the images themselves, the GCPs. Keep in mind, when we are implementing GCPs on the photos, we need to do at least two different images per GCP to have a superposition of data, which suggests to do at least three GCPs to have a pertinent result. Once we're done picking the GCPs on the images, we will edit the GCPs. And by editing, I mean giving them a coordinate XYZ. So we'll click on File, Control Point Edition, and then you have your GCPs, a tab of your GCPs, to which we'll have to edit the XYZ coordinate for all of them. Keep in mind that every time you enter a coordinate for each field, to press Enter to validate your entry. Once you're done, we go to GCP registration and confirm the coordinate we entered into a GCP registration. Then the software will apply with GCPs and create a new bin, .bin file. So I suggest you to change the name to adjusted or georeference as you wish, to be able to make the difference between the first .bin created by the reconstruction and the second one created with the GCPs registered. Then, as usual, the last step, we'll go to Densify and we will select this time the new .bin file created after we changed the GP coordinates. And we'll let the system do the rest for us.